Hi, I'm Shenelle.
And I'm Gennelle.
And this is
Shenelle and Gennelle, where book talk meets culture.
Where our mission is to share books that are accessible, culturally relevant, and engaging that may help your struggling or reluctant reader. So today's book, we have two. It's a sequel. We have New Kid and Class Act. So first, let's summarize for you what New Kid is all about.
So New Kid is about a young boy named Jordan, whose parents sent him to an elite private school in Riverdale. And he's learning to navigate this new experience and this new culture, as he is the only one of, not only, one of very few people of color in the school. He kind of goes through this identity of trying to struggle between who he is, who he's becoming, but still maintaining his identity from his community.
Yeah. And then we have Class Act, which is a sequel to New School, and it continues on in the same setting. Actually, this character's name is, but now it focuses on Drew, which is Jordan, one of Jordan's best friends. And Drew comes from a different part, I believe the Bronx, and he is now navigating how it is to be a black student in a prestigious white school. And him navigating that, also dealing with identity, race, class, and he struggles with where he belongs. He was taught with his by his grandmother that he'll always have to work twice as hard. And in this book, it's revealed to him that some of his classmates have a very different life from him. And he struggles with that, you know, a very big class struggle. His grandmother's an older woman that's working well into her elder age, and then she hit one of his best friends. Mom is just staying at home doing yoga. And he struggles with that.
Yeah. To accept his wealthier friend, who is Liam in the book.
Yeah. So he's struggling where, like, can I really be who I'm supposed to be or who I am, or true to who I am, and still have a good relationship with this person who doesn't know or understand the lifestyle that I'm living or where I come from.
Right. Yeah. So to make some similarities and differences between the two books, because they both talk about racism, microaggression, class. So Jordan comes from like a middle class black community, and Drew would be considered like a working class community, so to put it. In a sense, like his mom, you know.
I would say they're more working class. I think their family dynamic is different because Jordan's parents are together. He lives in a two-parent household. His parents are both working. Whereas Drew, he's being raised by his grandmother, who is basically an elderly woman who's still working.
A single parent. The differences between the two, and I think in how the books are structured, Jordan, like you were saying, Jordan is finding his identity, whereas Drew, his perspective of how others see him is a little different because he's darker. So in the second book, they do point out like biases in terms of colorism. So in the second book, you realize that Jordan is, although he is one of the black students, he's almost considered not black enough to be one of the black students.
Yeah.
So the first book talks mainly about Jordan. The second book talks about more the school wanting to be more diverse and have inclusion and them being aware of the diversity and inclusion that they need, but not identifying that Jordan is also black just because he's light-skinned. Anytime they want something done in the school, they call on Drew because they want that representation of blackness to look a certain way. He fits the narrative of what it means to be black. They have this, they point out all these, the single story narrative is definitely brought up in the book throughout the book.
So they definitely have a lot of stereotyping of Drew, I believe, in the second book. In the first book, I believe that Jordan is really like trying to navigate how he's going to work between the two worlds. And Drew is doing the same thing, but Jordan even realizes that Drew is treated differently than he is in the school. From the first book, that if there was an aggression, if there was some kind of fight, they will always think that Drew was the initiator. Right, Jordan will always kind of like get the benefit of their doubt for some things, and then they later realize like maybe it's because he doesn't look as black as Drew did. What I liked about this book in particular is how very direct the author was and very transparent in just
expressing the experiences that students may face if they're, let's say, one of few of a certain group in their school. Like, there was no sugarcoating any topic or issue in this book. Everything was head on, straight on, said as it is. Like, you know, teachers would make jokes that could be considered racist, and students would say things to seem cool and saying, oh, well, you know, like they're pretending to be black, like that's a thing.
Right.
And yeah. And I like how they addressed it and was so head on with it, because I think in the beginning I took this book for granted. I was reading through it and I'm like, oh, okay, it's cool, it's good. But I felt like I was like kind of sitting back like, oh, why is, okay. Like, I kind of like read so acid. Like,
I kind of, no, I for me, what I thought was, as I was reading the book, I was like, oh, this book is good, but it felt very like normal. And then I realized, oh, this is normal because I'm speaking from a black woman. Like, this is not, this is, yeah, they're highlighting, this is what a kid feels like when he's the only one in his school. But for a lot of black people, this is like, we are all, usually in a lot of settings, we're like the only one or one of very few. So a lot of the experiences are just very common. I think it's way more, it's probably more eye-opening to people who are not of color, because like, oh, this is how this feels when you say this. This is microaggression. I think it highlights those particular features of the book.
Yeah.
Do you agree?
Yes, I agree. And something that caught me in the book is when they were trying to be more inclusive and then showed a movie in the book about this black character that had the most stereotypical life and living in the hood and got shot and gang violence, and you're like,
one story narrative.
Yes, and how that makes the character feel. I think sometimes when people intend to do good, they don't necessarily always think about how that group or those other students may feel. Like, in general, you know, how that's panned across. So let's go into ACE. Is this book accessible? So this book, I would say, is accessible. It's actually, they're both graphic novels. The chapters are not very long, but the reading is very quick.
Yeah, so because it's a graphic novel, it does make it accessible in the sense that graphic novels, even though a lot of time people are like, oh, they're not real books, which they highlight a lot in the book, that teachers usually say that. Graphic novels are really great for struggling or reluctant leaders, because while the text is chunked, for one, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's a lower grade reading level. It just means that it helps the reading and the pictures help with the comprehension of what's going on. In addition to that, the topic and the topics that are covered in the book are not like, they're mature topics per se. They're mature and appropriate topics. So it's not like, oh, you're someone who's a reluctant leader, you're giving them a picture book that's not appropriate for their grade. Right, so that's the great thing about graphic novels. So that's why I always like, they usually help with the accessibility.
Yeah, this graphic novel in particular. I also think that this book is ranged between, recommended between ages, I would say 9 to 14. So, which is pretty good. And the graphics do help in comprehension. And it has a good pace to it. One thing that I even got tripped up with was, and you might have to support some readers with, is like when you read comics, if they're not familiar, you have to show them where to go to next.
Okay.
In some areas, he does have like arrows, like read this bubble next, but sometimes I find myself skipping. So I think that's something you might have to review.
Okay. Okay. When it comes to cultural relevance, I think we touched on this a lot already, that it is culturally relevant in that it does address a lot of cultural biases, microaggression, race, attitudes towards race, even administrations attempt to diversify and make inclusion and start including others. I think it's directly stated, but it's also very humorful in the, it's also covered with humor in the book in a sense. But I think like it's definitely a book I say that it's not written just for like black teens. I feel like a lot of black teens or black middle school kids will be able to relate to it because it might be their experience, but it's also a window for others who are non-black to see what it looks like to be a minority when you're in a group of majority white people.
Yeah, to be the person of color that is not the majority of the school. Yeah, so I definitely think the book does that.
So we did the accessibility, we did the culturally relevant and engagement. Now, were we like engaged throughout this book?
For me, I was engaged throughout the book, and like there was a lot packed in. I have to say that it helped me turn the pages. It's a graphic, it is a lot of content packed into the book. I personally liked book one, New Kid, over Class Act. Mm-hmm. What was your favorite part?
Mine was Class Act. I felt like I could relate to Drew more. It was engaging for me. I felt like because there's so many heavy topics, my mind constantly was thinking and making connections to other things, and I had to pull myself back in. But it is engagement. I think that very, very engaging. I think that these books can be used to facilitate some really, really great discussions and topics in a classroom. And it's a way, I think, for teachers, educators, parents to go head on with these topics and not shy away from having these conversations about race, class, ethnicity, home, family dynamics, mm-hmm. and structures. Mm-hmm. And I think the fact that, especially in the second book, that the author includes Liam, which is the white classmate that they're friends with, it really gives us gave me a window into his world. So I think that it's not only written from one perspective, but it gives you a panoramic view of like how each character, especially in Class Act, for me, mm-hmm. Is really handling the dynamics of being who they are in a school of varying classes, mm-hmm. pretty much, and ethnicities. Highly, like, majority white and privileged, but those that are, you know, those that are not privileged, those that come from different family dynamics, even Liam had mm-hmm. a family situation that was, you know, unique to him. Yeah. So, overall, I think that's, like, pretty much why I kind of resonated more with Class Act.
Yeah. I like them both together, but I'm going to say, like, I think both books is definitely a book that most middle schools, if not all middle schoolers, should read, and discussions that are brought up are definitely something that every teacher or parent should engage their student with.
Yeah. So, let's say, long story short, New Kid and Class Act is aced.
Bye.